Welcome to Metric Prefix Conversions. We will review the various metric prefixes and then take a look at how to convert from one prefix to another. So the prefixes are given here on the left, and each prefix has a symbol. The base is the metric unit used with the prefix, which we will get to in a moment. Each prefix represents a specific number, and that number can be expressed using a power of 10. The base units are the metric units used to measure some quantity, and so can be attached to any prefix according to the quantity. For example, there can be megagram symbolized mg, which is 10 to the 6 grams or 1 million grams. At the other end of the scale, let's say a meter is our base unit. So we could have a nanometer, which would be symbolized nm, which is 10 to the negative 9 meters, or 1 billionth of a meter. You can see that expressing the amount as a power of 10 is much more convenient than writing out the zeros in very large or very small numbers. So any metric unit can be attached to any prefix, which gives the unit a specific numerical value. And we use the prefixes to represent any number. For example, 2.6 million grams would be 2.6 megagrams, or 2.6 mg, or 2.6 times 10 to the 6 grams, or 2,600,000 grams. 18.2 billionths of a meter is 18.2 nanometers. So now let's take a look at how we can convert from one metric prefix to another. To gain an easier perspective, let's put everything in a horizontal table. And we will begin with meters and grams for our base units. This table allows for an easy view of each exponent, which we will need in the conversions. For example, how many decigrams are in 2.6 kilograms? We will use a specific algorithm that uses the dimensional analysis setup as follows. First step, write amount and unit given in the problem, then multiply by a fraction with the unit given on bottom and unit wanted on top. Now we need to fill in the numerical relationship between decigrams and kilograms, which is where we now refer to the chart. We put a 1 with the larger unit, which is kilograms, and the smaller unit gets a power of 10, determined simply by subtracting the exponents represented by the prefixes. Kilo has an exponent of 3, deci is negative 1, and so the difference is 4, which becomes the exponent. There is 10 to the 4th, or 10,000 decigrams, for every 1 kilogram. With this setup, the kilograms cancel, leaving the desired unit, decigram. Do the math, and we get 2.6 times 10 to the 4th decigrams. We have determined there are 26,000 decigrams in 2.6 kilograms. Click on this link if you need to review dimensional analysis beyond what is presented here. Let's try a problem where we are converting from a smaller unit, nanometers, to a larger unit, centimeters. The setup is the same as before. Write down what is given, multiply by a conversion factor with the unit given on bottom, wanted unit on top, large unit gets 1. Number for smaller unit is determined by subtracting the exponents represented by the prefixes. Nanometer cancels, leaving centimeters. 18.2 nanometers equals 1.82 times 10 to the negative 6 centimeters, or 1.82 millionths of a centimeter. But the purpose of scientific notation is to forget about dealing with lots of zeros, so we can ignore this. So any metric unit can be used with the prefixes, for example, liters, or seconds, or joules, or pascals, or watts. A common unit is milliliter, or 10 to the negative 3 liters, or microseconds, a very short span of time, or terajoules, a lot of energy, or kilopascals, a common unit of pressure in chemistry, or gigawatts, a billion watts. If you're a fan of Back to the Future, you may remember Doc Brown speaking in terms of gigawatts to power his DeLorean. He may have pronounced it oddly, but gigawatts probably has more levity than gigawatts. The last part of this video is concerned with unit conversions of squared and cubed lengths. Length units, such as meters or inches, are interesting because squaring them gives us area and cubing them gives us volume. And so that changes the conversion because numerical relationships also have to be squared or cubed as well. Let's look at a couple of examples. What's the relationship between square meters and square kilometers? The initial setup is the same as before. Units given on bottom, units wanted on top. What changes is their numerical relationship. First, we add the linear relationship given by the table. There are 10 to the 3 meters in a kilometer. However, squaring the linear units requires that we square the numerical relationship. So there are 10 to the 3rd squared meters per kilometer squared, a million square meters in 1 square kilometer. Last, let's take a look at cubed lengths. Here, the relationship between centimeters cubed and decimeters cubed. Note that a cubic decimeter is 1 liter. This is how liter is defined. The problem is how many cubic decimeters are in 44.5 cubic centimeters. Again, same setup using a conversion factor with given units on bottom and wanted on top, with the larger unit getting 1. Subtracting the exponents of the linear relationship gives an exponent of 1, but the units are cubed, and so we cube the numerical relationship, giving us 1 cubic decimeter for every 1,000 cubic centimeters. 44.5 divided by 1,000 equals 0.0445 cubic decimeters. So for squared length, which is area, the linear relationship is squared. For cubed length, which is volume, the linear relationship is cubed. You should memorize the prefixes and the exponent each one represents. These prefixes are used extensively in science, and you should have them in your head for immediate recall. You won't get to use this chart on a test. See ya.